Hi, everybody. Happy September. I hope everyone had a wonderful holiday weekend. We've had a decent market here in the last couple of weeks. In fact, we finished strong as August wrapped up. And, you know, we're getting into the fall here, and a lot of folks are wondering what's in store for the rest of the year. And I think it's important to take a bit of a step back, actually, and talk about what's happened so far this year. We came into the year with expectations that we would have a correction, which we got in January and February. We also thought that small caps would do very, very well, and that's certainly been the case. Small caps have been the standout area of the market. The market is the index, the S&P 500 anyways, is up about as much as I would have thought this year, maybe a little bit behind even compared to what we would have thought at the beginning of the year. We've had good performance out of tech, out of healthcare. Financials have performed a little bit better here lately. I think all of those areas and all those ideas I still think are very much valid at this point. Really don't see any reason to shy away from any of that. I've been getting a lot of questions about another correction. I don't think that we're in that mode right now. Anything could happen in the short term, obviously, but I don't see the market overbought at this point where it's susceptible like it might have been back in January. We'll have to see, obviously, how this plays out. But I do think the value side of the market, a lot of folks have said, well, maybe it's time to switch into the value side of the marketplace. My metrics that I use, the numbers that I look at, imply that we are going to see better relative performance out of the value side of the marketplace. And then we're going to need better performance out of sectors such as financials, perhaps energy, industrials, those kinds of companies, materials companies are perhaps what's going to drive the value side. But it's going to take a strong economy, I think, to drive some of those stocks. Those are cyclical industries. I view this as a chance maybe to rotate into things that are maybe a little bit more cyclical. And then what's interesting about that is investors are very worried about the economy. Even though the economy has been performing better, a lot of folks actually think that we are staring at a recession here in a fairly short period of time, maybe next year or the year after that. And obviously, if you think there's going to be a recession, you don't want to own things that are cyclical, maybe for a little while, but investors are not all that interested in that sort of thing. My work, when I dive into these stocks and I take a look at valuations and I take a look at the financial performance these companies have, and also look ahead and map out, well, what could happen over the next 5 to 10 years, I'm finding for a lot of these companies that are cyclical in nature is their share prices already have a recession baked into the share price. And what I mean by that is if we assume, for example, companies do well for a couple of years but then have a sharp decline in their business, let's say they're cyclical, maybe they're industrial in nature, and every time we have a recession, we see returns on their businesses fall down to very, very low levels. In many cases, when I map that out and look ahead, I actually get a share price that is not too far away from what's actually on the screen. In other words, the market is looking ahead. The market already sees that we are going to have a recession at some point in the next couple of years, which I find very, very interesting. Now, the longer we go and we don't get a recession, then that means there's upside potential for some of these companies. So I think one of the real opportunities right now in this market is to buy things that are, yes, they're cyclical. We're talking energy, we're talking financials, maybe some areas of technology such as semiconductors would be in that same category. The market is basically pricing in the next downturn for a lot of these industries and a lot of these companies. So I think if you have any faith at all that the economy can withstand continued tightening by the Fed for the next year to 2 years, I think there's an opportunity for these companies to shine. A lot of these stocks are relatively flat year to date, maybe even down a little bit from where they might have been at the beginning of the year. I think that's where the real upside potential is. Now, the S&P itself, the S&P 500, right now, the consensus is that in the quarter right here that we're in right now, earnings are going to be up 20% compared to the same quarter a year ago. Now, last quarter or the quarter before, we ended up getting about 5 percentage points more growth than the consensus. So let's assume that we get that same 5% overperformance, if you want to think of it that way. We've got an index that's up 16%, and the estimates imply that basically we're looking at 20, maybe even 25% earnings growth. That's conducive for a market, I think, to continue to climb this wall of worry, because the companies that make up the index are ever more profitable, and that's where we see things unfolding here in the next couple of weeks and quarters, and I think through the rest of the year. So anyhow, it's always great to be back with you again. We will try to touch base with you a little bit more often here in the next couple of weeks. I'm looking at my schedule, and it looks like I'll be able to update things as we go. But it's going to be more macro, probably over the next few weeks. We don't have a lot of earnings reports. It's going to be more on the big picture stuff that's going to move the market. And it's hard to believe, but we're looking at earnings reports starting up again here in about 5 weeks. So obviously we're going to be all over that when that comes. But as always, thanks for checking in with us. We'll talk to you later.